So today we'll be discussing about the corpus callosum. This is the midline sagittal section of the brain. What you're seeing is the medial surface of the right hemisphere of the cerebrum. So this structure that you see on the medial surface of the right hemisphere of the cerebrum is the corpus callosum. Corpus callosum can be seen to have different parts. This part is called the rostrum. This is anterior and this is posterior. This is inferior and this is superior. This part is called the rostrum. The rostrum bends forward to form the genu. This part is called genu. Then it runs upwards and backwards, and this part is called the body. The body ends over here and this is called the splenium. So you have a rostrum. Anteriorly it bends to form the genu. Then it forms the body. Then it forms the splenium. Between the splenium and the body, you can see a relatively smaller constriction, and this region is called the isthmus. So this appearance of the corpus callosum, you see when you take a midline sagittal section of the brain. So imagine that this is the brain, this is the cerebrum, this is the right cerebral hemisphere, and this is the left cerebral hemisphere. This is the front and this is back. In that case, what you have seen just now is the midline sagittal section, and you have seen the corpus callosum like this. But you have to imagine that the corpus callosum is actually a three-dimensional structure, and what you have seen was just a two-dimensional representation of the midline sagittal plane. So imagine that this is the cerebrum. From this part of the cerebral cortex connecting to this part of the cerebral cortex, similar regions of the cerebral cortex on both hemispheres, you have a series of white matter fibers, and they are called the commissural fibers. So this point of the cerebral hemisphere is connected to the similar area of the cerebral hemisphere on the opposite side by a commissural fiber. Similar to that, you have millions of fibers connecting similar areas of the cerebral hemisphere. Example, from the frontal pole, you have commissural fibers connecting the frontal pole of the left side and the right side. Similarly, you have fibers connecting from the occipital pole of the right side to the left side. So you have a whole set of fibers connecting similar regions of both cerebral cortex, and that together forms the corpus callosum. So what you have seen before was the rostrum, genu, body and the splenium. The rostrum, genu, body and the splenium. So actually the genu contains the fibers connecting the frontal poles. The splenium contains the fibers that is connecting the occipital poles. Similarly, the entire parts of the corpus callosum is actually connecting different cortical areas of the whole cerebral hemisphere. So it is very important for you to understand that the corpus callosum is actually a three-dimensional representation, and what you see in the midline section is only a perspective of the corpus callosum. So now you are seeing a dissection specimen of the corpus callosum, where most of the cerebral hemisphere, the cortical part has been removed, and this is a dissection specimen of the corpus callosum per se. So this is a superior view of the corpus callosum. To give you an orientation, this is actually anterior, this is posterior, and you are viewing from the upper aspect, from the superior aspect onto the corpus callosum. Most of the cerebral cortices have been scraped off. So this is anterior and this is posterior. This will give you an idea that actually this is the genu, this is the body, and it ends in the splenium. This is the splenium. So the genu is basically having the fibers that is connecting the frontal poles. That is not shown here, but you have to imagine that that's scraped off. So the frontal poles or the frontal cortices has been connected by the fibers that is running through the genu. And you understand that this looks like a U fiber that is connecting the right cerebral hemisphere frontal pole to the left cerebral hemisphere frontal pole. These set of fibers are called forceps minor. So forceps minor is actually the part that is going through the genu. But if I turn like this and reach the splenium is the fibers that is connecting the occipital cortices. This is the right occipital cortex, and that is being connected through the splenium to the left occipital cortex. So this is a larger U if you compare this U. So this is called the forceps minor fibers, and this is called the forceps major fibers. So this is the splenium containing the forceps major fiber, the body, the genu, which contains the forceps minor fiber. Now, if I turn this around like this, you can see the genu bends to form the rostrum. You are now looking at the inferior view. So this is the rostrum. So if I now turn run my finger through the entire corpus callosum, you have the rostrum, genu, the body, and the body ends at the splenium. So these are the parts of the corpus callosum, and this gives you an idea that the corpus callosum is basically a three-dimensional space, like a three-dimensional structure which has a spatial dimension. To understand this better, we are going to see an axial section of the brain once more, and this will give you a different perspective of the corpus callosum. So this is an axial section, this is the front and this is back. This is anterior and this is posterior. And you have to identify this. These are basically the lateral ventricles. This is the occipital horn and this is the frontal horn of the lateral ventricles. So we are going to see the corpus callosum in this perspective. This is the corpus callosum. This is basically the genu of the corpus callosum that we saw before. So the genu is containing the forceps minor fiber connecting the frontal poles of the right cerebral, right frontal lobe to the left frontal lobe. And this is containing the splenial fiber which is connecting the occipital pole of the right side to the occipital pole of the left side. So this section is basically going through the genu in front and the splenium behind. So this different perspectives gives you an idea of how the three-dimensional orientation of corpus callosum is, and you have to understand the corpus callosum as a three-dimensional structure and not just in the median sagittal plane. Thank you.